Hi everyone, this is Seshanand. I just want to give a video on LCD 4-bit mode. So we have some Aerotech solutions. We are giving more microcontroller videos on different interfacings. Okay, so you can follow us on YouTube and Facebook, the name Aerotech Solutions. So the main motto with this application is very clear. I just want to interface how to work with this LCD screens in 4-bit mode. So generally the intention of LCDs with 4-bit mode is very clear, to reduce the number of IO pins uses from microcontrollers, because as an application you may get different peripheral interfacings in one application, so that you need to avoid using more number of IOs for only LCD. So generally for LCD screen, so you need to use 11 IOs along with data lines as 8 and 3 control pins RS, RW enabled. So to reduce this number of IO pins, 4-bit mode is best way, so that you can deal with only 6 IOs in 4-bit mode. So this is your application block diagram representation. So anyway, power supply unit is required for converting AC to DC source, and microcontroller is your programmable device which supports to run your programs, and LCD is our peripherals. Now so I'll show you the simple circuit with this. See the hardware connections with this. So I'm just connecting only 6 IO pins, as RS pin is connected with P2.0 GPIO pin from port 2, and RW is grounded because you're always trying to make read write logic as 0, because every time you're writing the values to LCD screen, so that no need to read anything from the LCD. And enable pin is required to make sure high to low operations, so that you have to connect your enable compulsory with the GPIO. And so here I'm not working with 8 data lines. So I'm working with only MSB part of data lines, as D4, D5, D6, D7. So LCD itself, it contains internal controller. It will manage your data as one character, but you can pass it as 4 bits just by dividing your entire character into 2 parts. The first higher part you have to send first, and then make sure enable high to low, and again you can send the previous and remaining part of your data or command. So again, your LCD deals with commands and data. So commands required for LCDs, which decides cursor position and moving left to right or right to left and doing scrolling operations, all these different operations you can go through this commands list. And LCDs requires some proper commands to perform specific operations. See, with 6 IO pins I can manage my LCD. This is the main motto working with this 4-bit mode. Now I'll show you the source code of this application. You can go with your LCD 4-bit mode now. So this is my application source code, which is already developed in Keel IDE. So most of you are of how to work with this Keel Microvision IDE, and there are some proper steps you have to follow to create a project and to choose your microcontroller from different families and different manufacturers. And you can open your text editor and you can start writing program. And after writing your text program in text editor, you have to save with .c extension. and this is my program, and I'll explain line by line. So this is your reg51.h header file. So this is for all 51 families, which supports to use all SFR register names directly without any declaration. And see these two IO connections. Here I am trying to connect P to 0.0 and 2.1, and the four data lines I just connected with 2.4, 2.5, 2.6, 2.7. Now, so I am using some user defined functions, which are initialization and command and data and delay, and whatever the string you are expecting on screen, you can use this string pointer. And here from main logic starts. Now I'm calling the first function, which is initialization. Now let's see the description about this LCD initialization function. So here I'm just giving some commands. I'm passing these commands to LCD screen, which is 0x02, which is display mode in 4-bit, and 0x28. This is for selecting your LCD screen in 4-bit mode, whereas 38 for 8-bit generally. And if you are trying to display anything on LCD in 4-bit mode, you have to pass this command. And 0x0e, I think this is two times, no need to give two times, it's one time is more enough. And 0e for making display on cursor blinking, and 0x06 for shift cursor position to right, and 0x014 for make clear screen, and 0x80 command for start first line first position. These are all commands here you passing as argument to this LCD command function. Let's see this LCD command function carefully. Whatever the argument you are passing from this initialization, it will reach to this function as argument, and see this operation here very clearly. So you're making masking the MSB part of your given character. Suppose each character contains 8 bits as ASCII standard. So now I'm going to mask the MSB part of this, LSB part of this given character by using this F0. So MSB part remains same. That MSB part I'm just passing through this port to higher part of IO pins. While passing command, take care of your control pins logics as RS0 and enable high to low ones. And after doing sending this MSB part of your value or character or command, so you have to make sure you have to keep your original value on MSB position, so that you are doing left shift 4 times. The complete LSB part of the value or command or data, which is shifted to MSB side by doing this shift operation, and again I am doing this masking part of this F0. So now you can pass the LSB part, which is moved to MSB side. So again you have to make sure enable high to low. This is your command passing from microcontroller to LCD screen just by doing two times. So first time you are sending the MSB part, and later doing left shift 4 times, you are sending the remaining part of your command or data. So this you are following for same even commands or data. So once initialization function, so this LCD command 0x01 for making clear screen, which is already passed in initialization. Now, so I am taking this LCD string. So this LCD string function, just come to this LCD string function description. I'm just repeating my loop until reaching null character. You know strings terminates with null character, which is \0. I'm repeating my loop until null character reaches. Within this while loop, I'm using this LCD dat function. Again, coming to this LCD dat function, each character we are passing one by one to LCD. So again, you are doing the same part, logic you are applying as command you discussed already. So first you are sending MSB part of your character, and the one change you have to observe here, you are making RS line logic as one, and enable high to low is same as, and doing left shift of your given character, you are passing the remaining data on your character. So that you will get error text solutions on screen. So with simple 6 IO pins. So generally you required 8 IOs. So let's say this application output with this design. So this is your produce tool you are using to simulate our output. So most of you no need to bring hardware directly. You can test your outputs with simulation tool itself, and later you can proceed with hardware, because buying hardware is always commercial aspect. So first let's check your outputs with simulation tool. If you get confident, okay, your application is working properly, then you can proceed with hardware. So you need to link your hex file just by double click on controller, this same. So this is already done. Now I'll run this program, see what you are going to get. So as AeroTech solutions. So this is as per your logic. If you are changing something on program, you will get the same text on your screen. See, with these 6 IO pins, you can manage your LCD. So this is the best way to prepare your applications with LCD 4-bit mode. Rather than using 11 IOs, you can finish your LCD interface with only 6 IO pins from the controller. The main motto is very clear. It reduces IO pins usage from controller. This is our channel from YouTube. So you just subscribe our channel to get more technical videos on microcontrollers and interfacings. You keep on sharing more technical videos in this channel. Please subscribe us and like, share, comment. And you're doing multiple services. You're doing trainings with online and classroom. And you will provide placements for experienced people, and you will do applications for academic engineering students and as well for small solutions. We have your own applications list. We are providing internships also. If anyone interested with any service, please get back us with this contact number 9676327118, and we are located near KPHB metro station at Hyderabad, Telangana, India. And if you have any queries, please email us with this mysnanda@aerotechsolutions.com. Please support us. Thanks for watching.